you a boy. Man, we been getting money for a long time. We was out here hungry for a long time. I don't never really had no punch lines. And all you rappers looking like a lunch line. Right now, right now, need crew love right now, cause we two up right now. Ooh, I'm up right now. Ooh, I'm up right now. First I pull up, hop out, ballet, walk out, all these bands I lost count, cause I'm two up right now. Two up right now. Yo, I'm two up, round blew up, copped that new rape on them haters, threw up, brought them went to jail for them, told me you up, first time I seen 100 bands, yeah I grew up, ooh, on the couch with my shoe up, and we was getting that record label money before they knew us, and we were blowing your budget in the club to the booth up, if your dog follow your ball hog and get your whole crew up, ooh, I'm with right now, I got you. Right now, nothing, need a Uber, right now. Right now, need crew love, right now. Cause we two up, right now. Ooh, I'm up, right now. Ooh, I'm up, right now. First I pull up, hop out, ballet, walk out. All these bands I lost count, cause I'm two up, right now. Two up, right now.
It's one of them ones, man. You just in the car, man. It's like when you in the car, you just think about everything, man. Definitely when you like you by yourself and you just cruising on the highway, man. Yeah, this got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through traffic, listening to traffic. My windows ain't tinted, so notice me. Four braids, Yankee fitted, yeah, know it's me. I'm everywhere comfortable, but I'm still attentive. A young with money will make offended. I ain't flashy, I'm classy, but I ain't stupid either. Never show up to that's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal, it's all in my demeanor. A true believer, I believe when they didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I wanna do. If they do or they don't accept me, they expect me to give up. I almost did. Things went from moving fast to slow motion. I was losing focus, stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you given. Gotta make wise decisions, gotta stay tunnel vision. Gotta avoid collision, keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit, it's been a while. I've been working, she keep telling me she miss her child. I find myself passing the house, then I spin around. She say I'm always moving, ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my, cause the cash ain't gon' come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a for us? So instead of making it hard, I made it fun for us. Make it easy, so when you need it, you just run to us. But it's a lot of pressure, I'm trying to stick and move through this. Fixing these bumps on the road so I can just cruise through this. Living my life on the road, I'm trying to get used to this. And when they throw dirt, I just act like a broom to this. Trying to stay true to this. Even when they lie on me, world on my shoulders, my girl can't even cry on me. God watching over me, the devil probably spy on me. I've been going through some, Kenneth keep an eye on me. I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture, don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire, I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see a bright of me. I'm sorry. I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. I came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I
I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Because there's no days off, there's no days off. I know it sounds a little painful, but it pays off. Social sites was distracting, so I stayed off. Spoke to God, then me and Satan had a face off. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. I put the pedal to the metal, then took the brakes off. And I kept it A1 like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started, spent my money on recording. Yeah, the studio was small, but man, that made me a fortune. Made me a fortune, man.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Atlanta Falcons and the Carolina Panthers. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Over the middle, open is Thomas. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
They'll look to throw here. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down.
By 20, by 90. Up, up. Orange, orange. Eagle, eagle.
Throw flushed out right, quick slant caught by Moore and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. So back-to-back big runs picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Tyler Davison forcing his way through there to drop him for a loss of a good 10 yards. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. That catch good for 5. It's third down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive, they like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
It's a gain of 5, and that'll bring up fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
So an opening drive field goal maybe doesn't whip this crowd into a frenzy, but I think that they will take the early lead.
There's no doubt about it. They will always take the early lead, and maybe that celebration comes later if they play well and they can break things open. But right now, this is all about letting the offense just get settled in.
Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 27. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Freeman again, a first down carry. Fights loose. Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman, touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. And, Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Tech McKinley in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year.
Hey, let's go!
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. He's got a man complete. A big third down play there for the Panthers. 51 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. At the 30. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And this is complete to Moore on the comebacker. 3 catches now this afternoon, the same number he had all of last week. Also, it's a first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 13. After the interception, here's Ryan. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
So this helps to start a drive. After the penalty, it'll be first and 5. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Man open, that's Calvin Ridley. Spinning again. He's still on his feet. It's a gain of 19 down to the 19, and it's a first down. And he's top 5 in the league in terms of receiving yardage because of plays like that. What have you seen from him on film that you like so much?
Well, I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth. When the ball's arriving and there's a defender there, he just comes down with the ball. He competes and takes it away. Great hands, great ability to finish the catch.
Now it's Ryan. Connects with Sanu right side. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game. Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2. They're up against a 3rd and 2 to start things out.
Hey, let's go!
One down to about the 10-yard line. It'll be called a gain of 2, and that'll leave them with some options here on 4th and inches.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks just like a quarterback would on offense to get them into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish, holding that to a minimal gain?
So a good snap, good hold, and right down the middle.
Never in doubt. Just the way you used to hit a button.
You mean like kicking the ball?
Exactly.
Well, that was in high school.
Doesn't matter. I don't care what level you hit them, they go through.
Carolina getting set to take the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got 3 on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete. From the 24, they'll go again on 2nd and 10.
Up, up. Wait, what's that?
He'll try again with the arm here on 2nd down. Going back to Moore. This time he's got him complete. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down. try to convert on third and six after the four-yard completion. They're going to look to throw. Got a man, it's right. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. His first catch of the game, good for 11 and a first down. This quarterback now, 9 of 11 passing in this first half. He's got his guys a first and 10. He'll drop to throw. And incomplete. Crisis averted. Almost picked. Instead, second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. He's going to go for a big play into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 44. From the gun, it's Ryan. Being chased out left. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll toss it to Hunt. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Moving backwards on first down, never a good thing. What does that do for the mindset on second down?
Well, it changes your play call, definitely, because as a play call, you're advancing yourself thinking, okay, we're going to get a gain here. Now you've got to go back in reverse, come up with something to pick up not just the yardage lost, but gain a few extra.
He's going to air one out, and that is going to be pulled in one-handed. Wow. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Calvin Ridley, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Here's Bosher to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys.
And for the third time here, this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation, but sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. They'll start with Hunt on the ground, and they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at them and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. Back to the ground, this time with Freeman. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Now Ryan on second down. He'll leave it for Hunt, complete. And he gets his down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Give him 3 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. Under 4 to play now. Clock running, third down.
Gun, gun, gun.
from the shotgun, Ryan. And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Ryan in the offense with a first and 10. And he's a perfect 6 for 6 here to start the ball game. Now Hunt. They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
On second down, here's Ryan. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And Thomas has it. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Hey, let's go.
A loss of 3 on that first down pass play, now second and 13. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Throw right side is going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Well, they don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Eagle, Eagle. Orange, Orange. Wait, wait, wait.
Back to throw here. Eluding the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Hey, 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 up, up. Wait, 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 wait.
They'll look to throw now on first down. That's going to be caught by Samuel. Now the ball comes loose. But fortunately, a Panther was able to get on this, so Carolina keeps the ball. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
By 90, by 20. Stop, stop, stop. Orange, Orange.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. That's complete, right around the 8. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they get it right at the 30-second mark of this first half. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down.
Check 50.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. The Panthers on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and four. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. He can run, and he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. It's their quarterback as the first half is winding down, and the Panthers are able to get this back within a touchdown. Gano the extra point, and this is back to an 8-point game. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Gano out to kick this one away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. And we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. That throw good for four. It's second down. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So out come the Falcons now. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. On second down, Ryan. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Kaywon Short, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. So the sack pushes him back, and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. Here's Ryan. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
And it's fielded at the 34. That'll be a 43-yard punt, but an net of just 33 following a 10-yard return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They'll come out throwing here on first down. That's Samuel, caught left side. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down.
We got three, fellas.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Out of the gun now on third down. And right through the here, over the middle. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. They chalk that one up as a gain of 34 on third down. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll take this one down near the 15. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
And as we've seen throughout this season, it's no picnic trying to score touchdowns against this unit. They're ranked number 1 against the run. But it's also difficult because it's not easy to throw the ball against them either.
That's caught. It's Thomas. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
The Panthers on third down. They've been excellent. 6 for 7. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. It's a quarterback sneak. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. They only got 2, but that was enough as they'll convert to make it 1st and goal. 2 of their 3 red zone trips so far they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on 2nd and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. Extra point try good by Gadeau. So that one will be accepted. And that will level the playing field at 17-all. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. Short, short kick. One of the up middle take it down. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They go play action here on first down. Oh, he got position on him and he pulls it in. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. To throw is Ryan. Sunil with a grab over the middle. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40, before being taken down. 23 yards on the play.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Now it's Hunt. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
Luke Kuechly combines speed, intelligence, toughness, puts it all together. It makes plays like one we just saw there. He may not be a big-time blitzer, but boy, he knows how to pursue straight ahead and make plays in the run game.
Play action. It's Ryan. There he goes inside the 30. And he will find Ridley on the left side. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those old reliable plays because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw there.
And those guys like it, right? They can get the ball with a full head of steam.
Especially against man coverage, because man coverage, they're typically running away from someone and not worried about traffic coming out on the other end.
They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. They hold him to only two there on the screen. It's second down.
They completed the screen, but one of the things you worry about is can the quarterback get rid of the ball before he's actually tackled? So your offensive linemen have to hold up the rushers a little bit because you want to make sure you keep your guy's jersey clean throughout the game.
Now Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Ryan to Jones, the Falcon connection there for a first.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So they've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? Here's Hunt. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Falcons have broken our tie. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Here's Bosher to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. Fake here on first down. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Tech McKinley in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. And they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Flushed out, in trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Grady Jarrett in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. After the sack, they'll come up now, 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. He sets to fire deep, and his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off right around the 43. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. Interception. Here's Ryan. He gets this one to Michael Crabtree. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. And we're back now in Charlotte. It's the Falcons. They've got the football. They've got the lead as we get set to start the 4th. Ryan now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's 1st and 10. A toss play to Hunt. He spins free. And yet again. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Brandon, sometimes it just comes down to the power of suggestion, because I know exactly what they said all week long. We're coming off the open week. We'll have the fresher legs in the fourth quarter, and they will wilt when we get to that point. And right now, it appears that they're thinking that exact thing.
Yeah, offensively, they had the bye last week. Defensively, did not. Is that really a big factor? Is that more talk during the week?
I think the more that you talk about it, the more that you emphasize it, the more sometimes it comes true for your team.
Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation when they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
Now they'll throw it with Ryan. This is caught. It's Sanu this time for a Falcon touchdown. Mohamed Sanu, his second touchdown on the season. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And they're able to up the lead by one more. Here's Bosher to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Throw left side, complete. It's right. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, a 22. They'll look to throw here on first down. His throw incomplete. The wideout, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And he'll get it down here to the 43. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. The offense on third down tonight, can't fault these numbers. 7 for 9 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches.
By 20, by 90.
They'll try and pick it up at McCaffrey. And the athleticism on the spin move allows him to pick up the first before he's brought down. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. Back to throw now on 1st down. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 14. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this is complete to Moore on the comebacker. And he's taken down inside the 30. 5th catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a 1st down. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Shotgun. He'll look to throw. Looking left side. That's caught by Moore. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 11 more yards there, and this methodical drive continues. They'll drop the throw. Stepping up. He's going to keep it. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Looked to me like they adopted what my kindergarten teacher always said. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And finally, able to hold him in check. He'd been carving him up running the ball.
That's the first time I think I've seen where the coverage was good downfield and they accounted for him and stopped him for a shot. And he will score! Touchdown, Panthers! Their mobile quarterback, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Panthers have got it back to a one-score game. Gano now to add the extra point. Gano the extra point, and now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Gano out to kick this one away. This is taken at his four. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all of their timeouts. So we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
Now it's Ryan. He's going to air one out, and he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to with you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle it yourselves.
I like that. Yeah, there was contact. I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 5 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Matt Bosher now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Carolina getting set to take the field. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter.
get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. He'll look to throw. And he'll go out of bounds just shy of the 20. Seven catches for him now in this last one, a first down. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
They'll look to throw. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early and then you kind of relax a little bit to step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play. Looks like they want to finish this one off.
Throw left side complete. It's Moore. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Eighth catch for him now. He's been a big factor. And it's a first down. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. He's back to throw. And right with it here, over the middle. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as they stop it here with a minute 7 remaining. A pair of first downs gives him a first and 10 up at the 44.
Eagle. Double. Right 20.
Back to throw. Complete to right. The 20. And he takes this thing way down into Atlanta territory. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. And two big plays, one after the other. Now all of a sudden, they're on the march.
Got to feel good about what they've just gotten done. And now feel really good about what's in front of them.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Back to throw. And avoids the contact by sliding. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout, as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. On second down, McCaffrey. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. Back to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Grady Jarrett in there to take him down. And the clock will roll. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And this is incomplete. So no miracles here on the final play. And this ball game is over. Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, your defensive guy. But it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was. And you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So for the Falcons, the win will help them keep pace in the playoff race as they move to 6-3 on the year. And they'll return home next week to take on the Jacksonville Jaguars. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, they'll lose an important one here as that drops them to 5-4 on the season. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the New Orleans Saints. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
I sound him.
Johnny Big Redemption, like, know what I'm talking about? Hold up.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah.
Yeah.
Get out the way, get out the way, come my way, yeah.
Yeah.
You either with me or against me, though. You either with me or
wait.
Win, 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 win.
Yeah.
Curve everything else. Win, 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 win.
Win.
These ops ain't.
really don't stay outside when I play outside. I put the beats on them like Dre outside. I got the bow outside and LA outside. And if you act bad, I bring the outside. Go and get your money. None of my know some funny. I can tell real by who you're running with. I'm all in the field. Duck hunt. Hit my just the. And he was like, boop.
Here.
Knew just what it was. Knew the whole but gave it back, boop.
Yeah.
9-11, no malice, baby. But no violence, baby. My got callous, baby. My bare knuckles got talent, baby. I'm all in the wind with it. On deuce line, I've been with it. She too fine, I've been. Crashed 2 times, I limo tinted my new ride. I'm riding with the 12 better not pull me over. Championship going dumb. Nothing to something, I won. Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah.
Yeah.
Get out the way.
Look at the cash coming in. Come get your man, slip book of bugging me. Just need a bag, quit out of jail, jackery. Don't even be that, I don't want none of it. He's bad about it, had enough of it. Whoa, watch what you saying, how the popping is shaking. Got is a laser, my posse deep in that rating. We act a fool for the paper, had a dream and I made it. El Camino on Dayton's, bitches guess over bait. Put the brand on me. I'ma bank it, pick it flat in the bank it. I might just roll out today. I might just roll out to Vegas, head back to my old ways. Cop a roof on it for all day. Look at me, baby. Look at me, baby. Don't I look like a million? I'm about to clean out the safe. Don't I look like somebody that just be bodying and everything? All that talking is great, but I don't be talking. I air it out. All the problems have gotten easy to bury. I'd rather kiss on my. I've been broke for way longer than I've been rich, so until it levels out, I'ma take mama to the Marriott. Took me so long to get it, gonna spread it out. Let them know all about me when I'm dead and gone.
One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. Look at the cash, look at the cash, bubba. Look at the cash, bubba. One in the hand. Look at the cash, look at the cash, bubba. Look at the cash.